Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise. If you're just tuning in, you're watching Spotlight. I'm your host, Jay Mournette, and joining me now are Pete Ellman and Brian Miller of the Pete Ellman Big Band. So welcome.
Thanks, Jane.
Hey, super excited to have you here. No music, unfortunately, and right. I certainly can't play. But Pete, we're going to start off with you. What made you decide to start the Pete Ellman Big Band, and why a 501c3?
Well, a couple of things. Growing up, when I was a kid, you could go out and see big bands all the time around the Chicagoland area. Glenn Miller, Tommy Dorsey, Maynard Ferguson, Buddy Rich, Woody Herman, all these bands, Basie, Ellington, they were around and you could go see them. As I got older, those bands stopped touring or toured a lot less. And so I just wanted to do something that would give us an opportunity for kids to come out and hear professionals perform big band music.
That's exciting. So. I mean, it's nice that you thought to, you know, you had such positive memories of that, right?
Yeah.
And why a 501c3?
Well, the reason I did the 501c3 is I thought eventually I might want to apply for grants to help out with things. And we've been doing that now. We have a jazz festival that started 5 years ago. We've now done five of them. And it's been really successful. I think the kids get a lot out of it. This year was at Neuqua Valley High School, and we had 22 bands join us.
Wow.
So, yeah.
That's quite something, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, Brian, talk a little bit about that, because now you're a Naperville resident, right? You've been a member of the band. You've been a band director. What does this jazz festival, what does this do for the students and for the community?
Well, sure. For our students, it's simple. It's just exciting to be part of a dynamic environment where they can be with students from 22 other schools who share common passions.
Yeah.
That's just great to validate the kids. Likewise, they can be in that community where it validates their hard work, because the people appreciate how very hard they've worked at this. The luminaries that Pete's brought in, we get education, we get inspiration. They get to hear a fantastic professional band play at a high level with renowned guest artists. And it's just one of those, hopefully, top five experiences for the kids in their high school career. And it just supercharges them to keep on the path they're on, doing really good things.
Yeah, that's such a great way of describing it. And I think, you know, jazz as a musical genre is such a collaboration, right?
Yes.
With the artists. So
very,
as you talk
so.
About that, you can feel that, right?
For absolutely. Sure. Spontaneous, exciting. Anything can happen. It's live music.
Yeah.
And it's very empowering to the kids.
So, Pete, obviously you're growing this festival. What might be one of the bigger challenges that you're facing?
Well, space and time are a couple of the things we're looking at. I'd like to add a concert at the end of the day. We now have one in the middle of the day. But it's nice to have one at the end of the day where afterwards the kids can come up and talk to the guest artists that we have, that we've brought in from all over the world. We've had people from London and people from Japan come. So. It's really a great opportunity, and these kids won't have another chance to talk to some of them. So.
Yeah, that's pretty special. I mean, that's a unique, you're bringing people together to do great music, but you're really, that's an educational process.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Yes.
I mean, access to people they wouldn't otherwise have the opportunity to interact with.
Yes, and they get the opportunity to hear them play. And they also have master classes now, so they get to go and hear the people talk about their specific instrument. So if you're a trumpet player, you can go hear a trumpet player talk about playing trumpet and how they started and what they did when they were their age. You know, so it's really a cool
yeah.
environment for them.
Yeah. Kind of sit at the feet of the master, if you
yeah.
will. Yeah,
yes,
that's awesome.
For sure.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Brian, you were one of the original members, right?
Yes,
of the
I
band.
Was.
So you've been around a long time with the band. What's been in your mind, like one of the best performances or just the best experiences that you've had?
Well, sure. That's a tricky one to narrow down, because Pete's done a great job putting together this world-class band where the repertoire from the band and their resume. We have people who played with Maynard Ferguson, Harry Connick, Ray Charles, all these luminaries. And then we've done all these great festivals, people from different continents coming, worldwide famous people. But I'd really probably bring it right back center court to Naperville, just the endearing. Our annual Christmas show, the swingin' Christmas with the Pete Ellman Big Band and our partnership with the Naperville Municipal Chorus. That's incredible because we're at a world-class facility right in our own town with Wentz Hall, just an incredible place to make and enjoy music. The community comes out in droves. And I remember last year on one of the rehearsals, it was a piece that we weren't playing, as we sometimes collaborate and sometimes alternate. And I'm just looking back and seeing 125 voices and the age range from early 20s to all the way up. And people who just lifelong love of music, absolutely passionate about what they're doing. And just seeing that raw enjoyment for the activity was just so great, and that we are a power of that. And I think we are there hopefully to inspire them and help them as professionals, but they no less inspired and helped us, I really believe, just because of the love of music that drew us into it for the first place.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Well, we were lucky enough to cover that concert, and you know, whether you were there sitting in the seat or you were watching it on television, it was amazing. I mean, as you say, and I think, you know, and this seems, I'm hearing this sort of ongoing piece about collaboration, and Pete, I'll just kind of wrap with you in terms of the concerts that you do, the collaborations that you have. What's coming up? What can we expect from you for the rest of the year and as you look into 2020?
Well, we're going to do another concert with the Naperville Community Chorus. That's coming up, and usually that's the first weekend in December. So December 2019, we'll be doing that, and that's Saturday and Sunday. And I don't know the exact dates yet, but we'll
be doing that.
It's
a great way to kick off the holidays.
It is.
It really
puts
you in the spirit, right?
It's awesome. It really is a lot of fun. And then we have coming up, we're playing in the Bolingbrook community. We're going to be doing a thing there June 28th. I'm not sure where the venue is, but it's going to be in Bolingbrook. We have some more things coming up. Hopefully we're going to do another fundraiser with Loaves and Fishes. That will be exciting, and that will be, I think, in July sometime. So
okay.
That's a few of the things we have coming up. But every week we have different schools that open for us where we play at La Quinta. And I think this next week we have a junior high from Naperville that's going to join us. I believe it's Kennedy Junior High or Madison Junior High. I can't remember for sure. But
either one. Yeah. One of them will be there, and it'll all be good music, right?
It will be, yep.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I mean, what a absolute joy to bring this form of music. It's one of my favorites, you know, to the community, to bring wonderful artists together with young people who are learning their craft, you know, and to see that play forward. So,
thank you.
You do a great job, and we look forward to hearing many more fine concerts and for next year's Jazz Festival.
Yes. Thank
yes.
you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. If you would like to learn more about the Naperville Big Band Jazz Festival or any of the other performances that the Pete Ellman Big Band will be performing this year, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go away. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.